Hey guys, welcome to Filmora Pro. My name's Johnny. I'm self-isolating like a responsible human being, as you should too. And today I wanted to show you 5 ways you can speed up your video editing in Filmora Pro so you can save time. Let's get right into it. This tip is one that you guys are probably familiar with at this point, but I thought I'd bring it up first since it's one of the easiest things to implement. When working with heavy footage or lots of effects, it's a good idea to lower your video quality for better playback. Obviously, you want things to look good when you're dialing in color or effects, but if you're editing and just trying to feel out the flow of your video, it's a good idea to try lowering your playback quality and making sure it's set to draft. You can still set it so that you get a full quality frame when you pause it by going down here. And of course, none of these settings will affect the final quality of your export. Let's say you're someone who uses certain music, graphics, or even clips in multiple videos. It can be tiresome to locate and import those files each time you want to have a new video to work on. A way you can save some time is to create a template. Now, when I talk about templates in Filmora Pro, what I'm talking about is a copy of a Filmora Pro project file with all of the starting elements taken care of. So I'll show you an example of how to make one. Let's say I do a weekly vlog and I use the same audio tracks, intro, and outro graphics, and the same folder structure in my media panel. Let's create a project with all of those things included, but nothing specific to the episode I'm working on. So I've got a folder in my media panel for audio, including music, one for video, which has folders inside of it for my front angle, side angle, and screen recordings, and finally a graphics folder with my intro and outro files. Great! So now I never need to spend that amount of time I did making this template for any future videos of this kind. Let's save this file as vlog template. And now when you start a new project, you can copy this template file and start working on your video. Filmora Pro comes with a ton of keyboard shortcuts that you can even customize to your liking. Now, you're likely familiar with some of the basic ones like Ctrl S to save, Ctrl C to copy, Ctrl V to paste, but let's look at some you might not be as familiar with. First, let's look at these 3 letters on the keyboard, J, K, and L. Hitting L plays our footage at normal speed, and hitting L repeatedly will fast forward your playhead. J will slow down, stop, or reverse your playhead the more you hit it. And finally, hitting K will pause your playhead. If you're scrubbing through a long video to sort through footage, these controls can definitely save you some time. If you want to look frame by frame at your footage, you can move forward and back a frame with the right and left arrow keys. Finally, if you want to skip ahead to the next or previous clips, you can use the up and down arrow keys. And when I'm cutting my footage, I often switch between the selection tool to move my clips around and the slice tool to cut up my clips. I can toggle between these pretty quickly with the V key for the selection tool and the C key for the slice tool. After familiarizing yourself with Filmora Pro, I highly recommend that you take advantage of different workspaces that you can set. This means if you're doing editing, you can use one workspace, but have another one for color grading and another one for working with text. You can even customize these workspaces and create new ones to match your needs. For example, you've probably seen that I don't use the default Filmora Pro workspace in a lot of my videos. This is simply because I prefer having fewer panels on the screen while I'm editing. If I wanted to adjust the editing workspace to my liking, I'd drag the viewer into the trimmer container and then resize the other panels to my liking. When I'm happy, I'll save this as a new workspace, which I'll name Johnny. One final note, if you work with multiple monitors, you can actually drag various panels onto a second screen if editing with multiple screens helps your workflow. Finally, if you typically use the same export settings for each project, you can set them so that they become the default setting. To look at our export settings, let's go to Window, Export. This will open up the Export panel. I'm going to toggle the Presets tab, and here we'll see all our presets. Let's say I'm usually making 1080p videos for YouTube. In this case, it probably makes sense to make that the default preset. Let's click YouTube 1080p HD, and click Make Default. Now if we finish our video and simply click Export, it will begin exporting your video immediately with those settings. So that's a few ways that you guys can speed up your editing in Filmora Pro. Are there any techniques that you guys use to speed up your editing? Let us know in the comments down below. If you want to learn more about editing in Filmora Pro, make sure to hit that subscribe button. And remember, there's no limit to what you can make. Well, I mean, unless you're planning to shoot a film outside, maybe don't do that. Yeah.